to see that ran aground very close to shore. It's amazing how close the barge was. The reportedly, the weather was bad, the visibility was bad, there was a high level of fog. But it's shocking to me how close it actually came. The barge has 2.5 million gallons of gasoline on it, and it is aground, and apparently it's sitting on rocks that extend out into the channel. The question, of course, is how to handle the barge and make sure that there's no leakage from the gasoline. That's what the authorities are discussing now, both with the company that owns the barge and the tug, as well as with the Coast Guard. The initial concept is to offload the barge, because if the barge ruptures where it is, as the tide goes down and there's more weight on the barge, that would be a significant problem. So they're discussing it now, what's the best course. Offloading gasoline is also not an easy process. That's a complicated process, and there's a possibility for an accident or spillage in that situation. So the options are being discussed. There will obviously be then a thorough investigation of why and what was the operator doing, etc., which will be left to the Coast Guard. But first order of business is how do we offload the gasoline and move the barge safely without any spillage. Our concern is the Hudson and the water and the environment. This is a water source for many communities, as well as the habitat, etc. A spill, a leakage would obviously be could have potentially catastrophic results. So we're going to stay very close to it. I want to thank the first responders who, as usual, have done an amazing job. We've had too much experience as first responders over these past few years. We did something that annoyed Mother Nature somewhere along the way, because she's sending us floods, storms, and now barge grounders. I want to thank Kevin Lewis, who's the chairman of Green County Legislature. I've had the good fortune to work with him a number of times, and he's a true professional. I want to thank Heather Batchelor, who's a Catskill Village president.